Окей. Let's continue. This could take a while. I praise the leftover sushi on the table and vanished into one of my soliloquies. Soliloquies. What should I do? Now that Toko's signature phrase, as his viewer has entered the fray, this isn't going to be so easy. Man. And the obligation is already as good as cancelled. As I said, I'm sure Toko will end up choosing Kako-san. But how is Kako-san going to react to that? I kick some ideas around while preparing some tea. Eventually I reach a conclusion. Well, looks like some drastic measures are necessary. I didn't manage to get any sleep that night. Hey Toko, it's almost noon, you know. I had come to check up on her since she still hadn't got enough. She was bundled up under her covers, showing no signs of coming out. What, are you sick or something? Do you need anything? Swiss as soon as you wake up, huh? Yeah. I moved your can of cookies from the table to the bed. Sit up while you eat, okay? What? Mine? She sounds like a little 4-year-old. Come on, actually, yeah. Besides, do you know how expensive this stuff is? I started on sort of cuteness, was it? Okay, fine. I prepared some juice for him, making sure to click my tongue loud enough for him to hear it. Because I need to show that I'm a manly man. Well, she's in higher spirits than I expected her to be, at least. Kyoko-san let out a sigh of relief and allowed the tension to flee her body. Yeah, she did say something along those lines yesterday. Kyoko-san, do you really intend to have Toko make the decision herself? I think you should give her a bit of a push, personally. Yeah, be all like, I won't hand my daughter over to anyone!
So, ne.
Her response was indifferent. What do you mean by that? That she was her mother and stuff. Hey, you shouldn't dwell on stuff like that. Kyoko-san just shook your head. Yeah, that's perfectly sensible. Kyoko-san, you haven't been sleeping much, have you? You've got these huge bags under your eyes. You should go clean yourself up a bit, okay? Also, it'd be great if you could cook dinner tonight. Do you really want that lie to stay alive forever? It's a promise then. Who knew if she would fall through on it
though? Oh,
A smile boomed on Toko's face. She ran to the bathroom.
Morita-kun-mo iku?
Don't go, go. I don't know. I guess I should. I mean, we're supervising her, so. But I don't know if you like be, how to say. What if we'll be ruining the atmosphere, you know? But yeah, let's go. Yeah, sure. Give me a bit or so. I need to do my morning dance, miss over Haikyuu, and check my body for any stray hairs.
Mada mada atsui ne.
But she was wearing long sleeves after all.
Cooler でも買おうかしら。
I'm up for that.
でもお金なかったわ。
I'll lend you the money. 1% interest today. What the?
あれ、ひなたさんじゃない？
Hey, don't ignore me. Wait, Nachan. Oh, it is Nachan. Hey. She was carrying a shopping bag.
みなさんお揃いで、どうもどうもです。
You out shopping, Nachan? What'd you buy? Tell me, tell me!
Okazu toka, seikatsu hichizuhin toka desu ne.
Do you like shopping?
Suki touyu ka, shikata naku desu ka ne.
Yeah, dude, I know exactly what you mean. Isn't it such a pain having to go shop for groceries all the time? That's why I always just grab some fast food.
お母さん、買い物を済ませちゃおうよ。
そうね、先に行ってるわよ。
I'm going to talk with Nachan a bit longer.
え、わ、私は…
行こう。
Toko just about dragged Kyoko-san into the store with her. So, how are things going recently? Anything happen?
いえ、別に、ぼーっとしているだけですから。
You don't ever goof off, you know, watching TV or reading manga or something. That's just about all Toka does nowadays, actually.
Yeah, ずっと寝てますから。
Wait, I'm not bothering you, am I? Sorry, especially when it's this hot.
Yeah, うざいってほどじゃないですけど、元気だなって。
I just can't help but worry about you, you know. I'm like a mom whose son has gone off to school in the city or something.
Morita-san は。
お母さんですか? Uh-huh. You guys lost more of the lights.
お姉さんはお母さんと仲良さそうですね。
What kind of question is that? Was she envious of Toka?
いや、別に。
Nothing really.
へえって思うだけです。私には関係ないですから。
Hmm. Depressing from head to toe, she was.
よく似てますよね。
You think so? Kyoko-san was always on edge, but Toka was pretty easygoing.
顔とか、目鼻立ちとか。
Oh, yeah. Oh, they're mother and daughter after all. Wait, huh?
どうかしました?
No, nothing. Yeah, they do, sure do resemble each other. Huh. Physically, no. Toka had been born to own a cocky and own a statue. And only Koki was Kyoko's younger brother. So that would make Kyoko-san Toko's aunt. Yeah. Well, in that case, it wasn't really strange that they looked alike, was it? Yeah, I get it. Yeah, makes sense.
それじゃあ、私はこれで。
I'll walk you home.
いいです。いいです。
Natsumiko was arms out in front of him and slowly backed away from me. Man, you don't need to run away from me.
さようなら。
She left. Jeez, she must really hate my guts. I waited around outside in a suspicious fashion until Kyoko-san and Toka came out of the store. Could you take any longer?
なんかやさぐれてるやつがいるよ。
ヒヒヒ、ウェンズディモン。
お母さんにアイス買ってもらってたんだよ。
ダーン、I want some too!
まるで子供ね。
Kyoko-san's bag was absolutely bursting with stuff. Kyoko-san, hey, Kyoko-san! Does the way I'm wandering around outside remind you of anything? Does it remind you of when you were a biker chick?
だから、それは Morita-kun の勘違いだって。
お母さん、こんなやつ放っておいてさっさと帰ろう。
そうね。
Yeah, okay. Will you hush?
どうか?
Huh?Kyoko-san abruptly shouted at Toka. Toka stopped in her tracks right in front of the kitchen.
どうしたの?
Kitchen?
私が作るから、あなたは Morita-kun と遊んでなさい。
Yeah, makes sense, okay. She really didn't want you entering the kitchen.
私もお母さんの手伝いをしたいよ。
And we already know what happened last time?
それは嬉しいけど。
この前ね、ケンイチと川辺で練習してたの。結構美味しくできたんだよ。
あは
その 昔、私がお母さんの料理の邪魔して、それで、勝手に痛い目にあって。
Took a finger to sleeve right where her burn would have been.
それで、お母さんが私のこと心配して、台所に入るのを禁止しているのはわかるんだけど、もう、大丈夫だから。
どうか。
あ、でも、お母さんが、それでもダメって言うなら、私はいいよ。
You repress even more your feelings? Toko, you don't need to keep holding back. She's not using your obligation to prevent you from entering the kitchen.
いいの。
So she would call Kyoko-san's wishes to the end, then. Kyoko-san slowly opened her mouth.
ごめんね、トーカ。今日は私が頑張って作ってみるから、楽しみに待ってて。
Why? Why don't you just prepare dinner together like a normal happy family? Always ended up taking Toka's side, huh? Are you really, truly that frightened that she'll have a relapse? Oh, that's sad, I knew that Toka didn't want me to stick up for her like this, but I did anyway. Okay, sure, if you both go into the kitchen together, it will be the same sort of situation as when she got burnt. Something that just didn't seem right, you know? That was an accident, wasn't it? Kyoko-san was being too stubborn about this. Being way too stubborn. That snapped me back to my senses. I realized that I was standing right in front of Kyoko-san, glaring down at her. I quickly averted my gaze, panicked.
あのね、ケンイチ。ケンイチは特別高等人を目指しているだけあって、今までものすごい速さで成長してきたのかもしれないよ。ケンイチっていつも物事を理論立てて考えてるみたいだし、落ち込んでも立ち直りが早そうな、そんな、強い人みたいだけど。でも、私たちは、普通の親子だから。もっと、ゆっくりなんだよ。私たちには、私たちのペースがあるんだよ。
That said, should you guys really still be dwelling on something that happened so long ago? Just how long were they planning on dragging this out?And advertently showed Kyoko-san a look filled with criticism. Toka noticed it, she grabbed my arm.
Kenichi.
Morita-kun, gomennasai.
Well, we sure weren't getting anywhere. Now I should apologize for sticking my nose where it doesn't belong.
Iie. Anata wa Toka ga fubin ni omoetan de shou?
I waved my hands in the air, hoping to brush aside her line of inquiry. Anyway, hurry up and fix me some foods.By the way, I am a...
グルメなんでしょ?まったく、厚かましいんだから。
Oh, just shut up! I'll make mince meat out of you. I pointed at the video game console in front of the TV.
ケイチ、ゲームできるの?
I can't do anything after all. I'll allow you the honor of playing with me until dinner is done.
偉そうに、ぶっ壊してやる。
Kyoko-san, your daughter is acting like a barbarian again.
え?何のこと?何も聞こえなかったけれど。
Oh, fine, I give up! Toka and I turned to the TV on while Kyoko-san carried ingredients into the kitchen. Toka seemed happier than she had been earlier, probably because she was going to get to eat her mom's home cooking. Time wore on, and soon it was the dusk. Dusk, sorry. Also, yeah, give me... couple of minutes... Well, not a couple of minutes, I just need to close the balcony. Alright. Let's... fuck! Give me a second. I'm not gonna... Okay. just when I close my curtains, I want it to be like closed fully, so you know it wouldn't be so light wouldn't like go through, like even like smallest cracks, because like I don't know, I don't like it. But yeah, let's continue. Man, this game is brutal as hell. It was one of those fighting game Shin Jama Jiggers. The system was pretty simple. You had different abilities and movements options depending on the character you chose. You basically just had to get the timing down, then predict what your opponent was trying to do. Then you could simply use whatever the right move for the situation was. However, I was paying the most attention to something that wasn't on screen. Whoa, what the hell are you doing, Davos? Whenever our matches in the game become particularly heated, Toko would start raining balls down upon me in level 5 as well.
Kono-kono!
You idiot! Look at the screen!
Urusai, urusai!
She had a pretty scary look in her eyes. Mom, is the food ready? I was at my wit's end dealing with this kid. I could smell the enticing aroma of various spices from the kitchen. Kyoko-san was sure taking her sweet time, but she really did seem to be putting her all into it. I've had just about enough of you. What? I've had just about enough out of you. It's just a game. You don't have to be mad. You both fell silent as soon as the phone started ringing. What should we do? What the hell is there to do except answer the damn thing? Go on, tell him clearly what you couldn't tell him yesterday. Toko went to pick up the phone material and her breath all the while. I'm going to leave his mom. She repeated that phrase over and over as if it was a charm of some sort.
Moshi-moshi. Oto-san? Iyo-iyo. Kino wa... 私も長話しちゃって。うん。それでね。うん。え？お母さん？うん。変わる？分かったよ。ちょっと待ってて。
Toko placed her father on hold and set the receiver down.
私？
Kyoko-san came out of the kitchen, dot painted across her face.
お母さんと話したいって、いろいろ謝っておきたいって。
Kyoko-san soundlessly picked up the phone. Did it sound like he was having a rough time of things?
とにかく、お母さんに謝りたいって。そして、できれば、一度会って、話がしたいって。
I guess he really was trying to make amends. Kyoko-san was conversing with him surprisingly calmly, could barely make her out.
ええ。あなたも変わったようね。そう。私は変わらないわ。今、幸せなの？一流レストランのシェフ？働き者で優しい妻もいるの？すごいじゃないの。まるで別人ね。
There was just a hint of malice in her eyes, huh? It would be more steep to compare Kyoko-san to a glass filled to the very brim with water. I was getting nervous just watching her.
それで、どうかも自分のところへ戻ってくれば、完全な幸せを手に入れられるとでも思ったの？
お母さん。
Kyoko-san's expression grew more and more grim.
親権の回復を裁判所に申し立てておいて、どちらの親を選ぶのかをトーカに任せるなんて、ちょっとずるいと思わない？
Kyoko-san must have had quite the story with Koki-san to be harsh, to be this harsh with him. Was she going to come out of this okay? She then so fit to pour oil upon the fire, my doubts.
黙りなさい！あなたとの縁なんて、とっくに切れてるのよ！今さら謝られても許すことなんてできるわけないでしょ。
The stench of burning meat wafted in from the kitchen.
あなたが
あなたがトーカに義務を負わせたんでしょ。そしてそんなトーカを私に押し付けて逃げたんでしょ。
お母さん、もうやめて。
Roxanne flings the receiver down as hard as she could. And yeah. Только approach Roxanne and grab her arm.
お母さん、ご飯食べよ。ね。
Roxanne just stared off into the distance, into space. Terribly empty expression on her face.
今日は野菜炒めなのかな。いい匂いがするね。
Только managed to smile amid the aroma of fetor of the burning meal.
そうだ。ご飯炊いた？まだ炊いてないよね。というか、炊飯器ってうちになかったよね。ふっかりしてたね。
That's...
Sorry.
Uh-huh.
早く、決めなさい。
何を？
What do you think?
何をですって？わかるでしょ？どっちの親を選ぶか決めろと言っているのよ。
I mean, I completely understand Kyoko in this situation.
そっか。
Toka hunched over and forced herself to laugh. I took one glance at them, then rushed into the kitchen to turn off the gas. Why didn't you do that earlier? The contents of the frying pan Kyoko-san had been cooking with no longer resembled what that witch we call a meal. All it held was a blackened lump that you could hardly call meat or vegetable.
Morita-kun.それ、捨ててちょうだい。
Kyoko-san screamed at me from behind.
そんな、豚でも食べないようなもの、誰が食べてくれるって言うの？
I mean...
I
tossed the contents of the frying pan into the garbage can before Toka could say anything further. Yeah, Kyoko-san had failed at cooking again today. The owner family's dining table remained unchanged. They weren't taking it slowly. They weren't proceeding at their own pace. They were frozen solid.Or perhaps, as we were moving backwards.
Toka, あなたが決めるのよ。自分で考えて、私とコウキのどちらを選ぶのか決めなさい。いい加減に、誰かにすがるような生き方。
She didn't finish her sentence. Kyoko-san's eyes, once narrow, were now open very wide indeed. She took a step back, because she was so weak.She took another step back, and another.
私の子供じゃない。
Well, that's pretty bad. She fled from the dining table like an animal pursued by hunters. Oh, that's really bad. Toka offered no response, she merely stood in place.She had been left behind, it would have been natural for her to cry. But she didn't, her chest quivered and her breathing grew ragged, but she didn't cry. Not a sound burst forth from those trembling lips. This was odd. I had put Toka to bed earlier, I was now lost in thought. I could not get the spectacle of Kyoko's son's rate of fright so out of my head. She couldn't seem to distance herself from Toka's situation, as a result she was unable to control herself when it really counted.She dwelt on the past so much that she could not even allow her daughter to cook. She could not even allow her daughter into the kitchen. She's a troubled individual. I stayed the house and went through the situation once more. The owner family consisted of a high-ranking government official and his wife and children. Kyoko-san and her brother Koki had grown up being treated coldly by the mother. When Kyoko-san's obligation had been cancelled, she went wild.She had ended up having to abort a child. Koki, who had left the home earlier, had ended up marrying a woman named Sasha, with who he had produced Toka. Koki had aside Toka her obligations, then had lost his right to parental authority, and then Kyoko-san, Toka's aunt, had become her legal guardian. And here we stood now. Toka's real parents, Koki and Sasha, had managed to obtain gainful appointments and were working hard to rebuild their life together.They had applied to recover their parental authority, but had stated that they would withdraw the application if Toka decided that she wanted to live with Kyoko-san instead. Man, this is some complicated shit. There was no doubt that Kyoko-san had grown slightly deranged due to the mistreatment she had received from her parents and the stress she had experienced due to having to raise Toka. I couldn't understand that she was feeling quite shaken up due to Toka's real parents showing up out of the blue and threatening to take Toka away from her right when Toka and Kyoko-san had made up, no less. That said, I couldn't excuse a witness. It was possible that she was still concealing something from us. Perhaps the reason why my supervision of Toka had not yet ended could have been attributed to the fact that all in the family as a whole had yet to be rehabilitated in the truest sense of the word. Rehabilitated. Rehabilitated, sorry. Whew. I took a draft from my pipe and stared up at the midsummer night sky. Sorry, Onision, but this is going to take a little longer. Pops summoned me first thing in the morning. He wished to discuss the matter of Toka's parental authority. I had brought Kyoko-san and Toka with me. Neither of them had spoken a word the entire way here. 早く解決していただきたい。ホスキグレートキョコさん。娘の親権問題をめぐって森田の特別高等人の試験が遅延しているのです。プーティンズプレッシャー。すみません。シュバウトがヘッドなポージ。ホスキ probably saw Kyoko-san as something like an insect after all she was delaying and official state exam with her own petty family matters。今すぐに決めていただけませんか。そのために。 Please wait, sir. They're still working out a few problems. I think it would be prudent to observe the situation for a bit longer. Exclaiming sound resonated throughout the room.
個人ののろまな足並みにペースを合わせていたら、社会が成り立たん。
Toko was beyond frightened. Kozuki pointed his cane at her forehead.
Kiro!
Kyoko-san was also stricken with fear. She couldn't move a single step. She couldn't even attempt to protect her daughter.
どちらの親だ? One Kyoko ka?
Striken?
One Kouki ka?
Striken or stricken? Striken, yeah. Or stricken.
お前は森田に迷惑をかけている。お前の親は人様に迷惑をかけてはいけないと教え育てなかったのか?
Kozuki attempted to force Toka to decide with a mixture of violence and intimidation. Toka tried desperately to force something, anything from his throat.
お母さん、お母さんがいいです。
Which mom, right, Kozuki?
どちらのお母さんだ?
ジスの母親か?
キョウコか? いいのかそれで? ジスの母親を捨てるというのだな? 悲しむぞ? 血のつながった我が子に裏切られるのだからな? お前のために必死で働いてカウンセリングも受けて人生をやり直したというのに
アジス、ホウソキ
そんな。それでもいいのか?
キョウコもひどい人間だ。 なぜ娘を本当の両親のもとに返してやろうとしないのだ?
アハ決めろ! Kozuki was acting strangely. He was telling her to decide, but purposely trying to make her waver in the decision.
どうしよう。
Toko looked back and forth from Kyoko-san to me.
あなたの好きなようになさい。
でも、でも…
Toko shivered like a small animal about to be eaten. Give me 3 days. As soon as I said that Kozuki nodded, it was like he already knew.
それまでに、お前が決めさせるというのだな?
Yes, if I fail to do so, then you may consider it a favor in my exam as well.
よかろう、急げ。
He finally lowered the cane he had been pointing at Toka.
もう帰っていいの?
Yeah, you two can go ahead. I'll go on ahead.
失礼しました.
Kyoko-san and Toka hung close to each other and left the room. What was all that about? I started asking questions as soon as the door closed behind them. If you really wanted her to choose someone, you could have made her, right?
娘の意思を尊重しただけだ。
Stop joking around. I had tried to make my voice as menacing as possible, but Hozuki was having none of it. He just shook his head at me.
そしてその意志が脆弱なものであるという、その過程を森田の工学のために見せておこうと思ったのだ。あの娘はこれから迷い出す。どちらの親を選ぶのか。正解のない問題に直面して慌てふためく。高等人はそんな愚かで歩みの遅い人間を導いていかねばならん。
In other words, I had played right into Pop's hands.
3日以内だ。必ず決めさせろ。人に決断させられない人間は人の上に立てんぞ。
I have the room with my fist trembling. Toko was already on the phone when I got back home.
うん。元気は元気だよ。特に問題はないかな。ご飯？うん。ちゃんと毎日食べてるよ。いや、外食が多いかな。あとお弁当。うん。料理はあんまりしないね。
I didn't see Kyoko sat in the living room.
甘いものが好きかな。子供だし。お母さん、あなたは？
とか was in the middle of conversation with Sachio.
電話は迷惑じゃないよ。お母さんも止めないよ。だから、いつでも電話してくれていいよ。いいけど、
I detected a hint of hesitation in Toko's voice. Hosuke's words earlier seemed to have affected her.
子供とかいないの？そう、新しい子。私の妹とか弟とか。え？そんな、そこまで私のこと。
やめさく。Maybe I'm hearing things. What were they talking about? Didn't seem like they had any more children yet, but.
I die. 私も一度会ってみたいよ。でも、お母さんがちょっと悲しむかなって。ごめんなさい。いいんだよ。私バカだから何も覚えてないよ。虐待なんて、そんなのなかったんだよ、きっと。
Did you probably attempt to apologize to her about the abuse in the past?
田舎町だからね。こっちの住所もわからなかったんでしょ？だから、気にしてないよ。そんな、今更だなんて思ってないよ。声聞けて、嬉しいよ。二人とも生きていてくれて、嬉しいよ。
Toko saw Celeste in the arms of others. She had lived her entire life under the thumb of her mother, so perhaps that was a natural conclusion. But would a girl like that be able to make this decision? Toko was on the phone for nearly an hour.
どうしよう。
How did it go?
Kenichi.
She ran up to me.
私、わかんなくなってきちゃった。
ん？
子供、作らないんだって。
Why？
私が一番大事だから、私だけをしっかり育てたいんだって。昔、私にひどいことをしてたから、せめて私を幸せにしてから、次の子供を作りたいんだって。
There is some issue.She didn't even pause to take a breath.
もちろん義務なんか使わずにだよ。向こうに行くことになっても義務はなくなるって。
I'm pretty sure you won't be here then, but still. Oh, that's a given.
がっかりするだろうな。口には出さないけど、私にそばにいてほしいんだろうな。
I guess it was time to try a few things. Hmm. нельзя speaking of Кёкусан Пичинс?
Иванайо, бака! Сонна хитотачи жанайн да ё!
Чего, стартин тут раса? Sorry, why don't you go live with them? You can have your dad teach you how to cook. She caught your breath. You'll never be able to learn properly if you're not allowed in the kitchen.
それは…そうだけど…でも、お母さん…教皇お母さんが私を今まで育ててくれたんだから…
My mother, was it? Yeah, Kyoko-san would be left all alone if you went to live with them. She couldn't control herself.
みんな一緒に暮らすっていうのはダメかな?
How you can even imagine that? Have you forgotten how Kyoko-san acted yesterday? She started acting like that just because she had to talk to Koki.
うまくいかないね。
I talk like sobbing a bit myself. We have to choose one or the other. Только стал ктоф in her room, her shoulders drooping.
Морита-кун.
Кёко-сан came out of her room, taking Toko's place.
Тока, нандатте?
I was a bit reluctant to tell her, honestly. Toko is in her room if you wish to speak to her. Ask her directly, dammit.
昨日のことを怒ってるの?トーカに向かって声を荒げてしまった私を。
Man, I just don't get you. I made eye contact with her. I mean, like. Okay, so just a little while ago, you were like, Oh, Toka, I'm so sorry for being so strict with you. I'll take it easy from now on. But yesterday you came out with, you're not my child. Seriously, that's crossing the line.
分かっているわよ。
She was feeling sorry for herself.
でも、うまく感情のコントロールができなくて。
She looked down, breaking eye contact. Fine, then. If you can't control yourself, why don't you just return Toko to her original parents?
それは…
She snapped her head back up. You don't want that to happen, do you? Then why don't you go talk about it with Toko? She's in her room, like I said.
あの子、怒ってないかしら?私、軽蔑されてないかしら?
How troublesome. Come to think of it, it's almost your birthday, right?
え?ええ。忘れていたけど。
It's 3 days from now on, right? Toko's really looking forward to it.
そう。少し、嬉しいわね。
She started blushing. Then why don't you show Toko how happy that makes you? I don't care if you do it by fooling around even. I'll help you out.
もう、そんな気分じゃないのよ。
Says the person who kept saying, oh my, and acted like a doting parent.
あれは所詮、お遊びだから。
Playing around his opponents, as a smiles. I just didn't get through to her. She shook her head at me and retreated back into her room. My eyes went to the telephone. Kyoko-san and Toko lived in the same house, but the difference between them was as wide as canyon. It was almost time for dinner. It had been quite some time since Kyoko-san had applied for the cancellation of Toko's obligation. However, she still had yet to cook a meal. Kyoko-san, ready for dinner? I tapped lightly on her door.
今日は気分が悪いので、いらないわ。
No, I mean, make some dinner. Sorry, make some dinner. There was a pass.
ごめんなさい、今日は。
I went to Toko's room. Hey, come on out for a second. I heard a muffled voice from the other side of the door.
何?
I thought you guys were gonna buy a rice cooker at some point. You can't really cook without one.
今日はいい。なんか、お腹痛い。
え? How does it hurt?
うるさい。
え?
いいから、あっち行ってよ。
Maybe it was that time of the month. Fine, I'll go shopping by myself. I'd probably end up eating by myself too. いただきます! What the fuck, Sachi?
あーい! って、なんで? ここ、トーカの家だよね? なんで家主がいないのに、私たちが勝手に飯食ってんの?
I've brought you here for a little project. You see, I want you to cheer up Toko with your energetic type abilities.
うわ、そういうこと! いきなり炊
飯器持って部屋に来て、ちょっと来いやとか言うから何かと思った。
So he bought actually it. So you understand what's going on?
どうか元気ないの？
Well, some stuff has happened recently.
私深いの苦手だよ。内面とか精神とか心の機微とか。
Yeah, that's fine. Just say whatever comes to mind. So she stared off into space for a bit thinking.
まいっか。私が絵を描いてる時も、トーカには応援してもらってたしね。
Alright, enough talk. How about here?
We.
So she barged into Toga's room without bothering to knock.
Konnichiwa.
Huh? Toga didn't move a muscle, such as the true mask have started her something. What? Started her something fierce.
何？なんか悩みがあるの？
あ、どうしたの、サチ？
いいから話してみ。
サチ leaned against the wall and crossed her arms.
ケイチ、サチに何か話したの？
何も聞いてないって。いいからほら、思ってること言いなよ。私が一番わかりやすく解決してあげるから。
Yes, that's actually pretty hard to say. She opened her mouth hesitantly.
Hora, hora, hora!
Toka is sad, resigned to her face.
私のお母さんってね。うん。実はお母さんじゃなくて、本当は別のお母さんがいて、そのお母さんとお父さんが私が一緒にいればいいって思ってて、でもお母さんが寂しくなっちゃうだろうから、どうしようって話。
あは、alright。
あ、うん、もう一回言って。
だからお母さんが二人いて、お母さんとお父さんお母さんがちょっと仲が良くなくて、それでお母さんがいいのかお父さんお母さんがいいのかどうしようって話。
うん、だいたいわかった。ただ、ちょっともう一回言ってくれる？
ごめん。私こういうのを筋道立てて話すの苦手で。
大丈夫、大丈夫。
お母さんと別のお母さん夫婦が喧嘩気味で、私がどっちか決めなくちゃいけなくて、それでお母さんのあれがこうで、
どうかって、あたしより国語ダメなんじゃない？
Now that you mention it. So she pounded her fist into her palm.
まあ、要するに、京子先生がトーカのお母さんじゃなくて、別のお母さんと本当のお父さんのあれが、ちょっとまずい系で、その辺シビアにどうすんのってことでしょ？
No, no, she had no idea what Toka had just said, did she?
そうなんだよ。
My God, they couldn't understand each other.
どうすればいいかな。
She started looking at Sachi with different eyes.
よし、そんなの簡単じゃん。
Huh?
お金がある家を選ぼう。
Right. Of course, you would say that. Hey now.
向こうの家の方がお金あるのかな。
Okay, I assume so.
それはそうだと思う。二人とも働いてるらしいし。
She didn't sound very interested.
でも、トーカも街を出たいって言ってたじゃん。ほら、川辺で騒いだ時さ、料理の専門学校に行きたいって。やりたいことやろうとするとお金かかるよ。私も最近ギャンブルやめちゃったから、マジで貧乏だしね。
そういうお金に釣られてみたいなのは、ちょっと。
何それ？世の中にはお金より大事なものがあるっての？そういう決まり文句こそ貧乏を経験したことのない何よりの証拠だよ。これ、偉い人の名言ね。トーカがこの街を出るってのは私も寂しいよ。でも人間、自分がやりたいことをやるのが一番だって。一生懸命やってれば、そのうちきっと、お金より大事なものがゲットできるんだって。
でも私、そこまで料理を。
She tailed off in the middle of her sentence and looked up at Sachi with important eyes.
サチみたいに、そこまで真剣なのかどうかわからないし、才能だって、あるかどうか。
や、その辺、私にもわかんないけど。
So she smiled broadly. It was a bit out of place, in my opinion.
好きならいいじゃん。やってみなって。
Out of place it was. That smile of hers managed to put both Toka and myself at ease.
なんか、ありがとね。
こういうのって、みんな気を使ってうかつなこと言わないかと思ったけど、サチは友達だもんね。いや、思ったことを情け容赦なく口にしただけだから。大変だろうけど、そういうのって実は答えが決まってたりすると思うんだよね。
え？
ああ、わかんない。とにかく頑張れってこと。
うん、よく考えてみる。
じゃあ私帰るね。あとはケンイチとごゆっくり。
You leaving already?
ゾイと仕上げが残ってるから。
Yeah. She tore out of the room, my wife and a hand behind her.
あ、またね。
Should I walk you home?
いい、いい。そんなことより、トーカについてたあげなよ。
So she made a rather complicated expression. What's wrong?
まずいこと言ったかなって。
You think so?
だって最後さ、トーカが私のこと気遣ってくれたじゃん。サチは友達だもんねって。
Yeah.
優しいよ、マジで。余計に悩ませちゃったかも。
Nah, you're just overthinking it. Oh, probably.
家族の深そうな問題でしょ。結構追い込まれてると思うんだよ。私だったら、あんたに何がわかんのよって、打ち切れてるよ。
Just feeling driven into a corner.
見た目より、全然やばそうだよ。
I see. Thanks.
じゃね。
Wait. So she left. I realized the significance of such as words when I returned to Toko's room. Toko was so busy writing all those things that she had not even noticed my entry. Toko?
Kenichi.
She approached me just as I was studying.
Sachi の言う通りなのかな。私、好きな料理するために都会に行くべきなのかな。でも自分のことばっかり考えてていいのかな。あ、いや、サチみたいに才能があって真剣ならそういうのもいいと思うんだよ。違う。別にサチと私を比較してもしょうがないんだけど、なんていうかよくわかんない。
Just like Sachi had said, Toko was worrying about this way more than I had anticipated. You're not going to choose Kokyo-san? She was completely lost.
お母さんと一緒に暮らすつもりだったけど、向こうのお父さんとお母さんの声聞いてるうちに、なんだか、かわいそうになってきて。
But won't you just start feeling sorry for Kokyo-san if you chose them? Choose them.
そうなんだよ。だから、困ってるんだよ。
She was about to burst into tears.
母さん、今日お母さんは、私を今までずっと育ててくれたのに。
However, Kyoko-san is a bit unstable, right?
疲れてるんだよ。最近はいろいろなことがあったから。
We weren't making any progress here.Maybe it would have been best to just follow Pop's lead and try to force her to choose one or the other. I was gonna fail this thing if she didn't decide in 3 days after all.
Kenichi, どうしよう。何かいい方法ないかな。
Actually,
Nani?
If she were Poppy, her tail would have been wagging right about now. It would have been all too easy to make her do exactly what I wanted her to do.You should think about things in the morning. My time is for sleeping, not thinking.
何それ。
I could see that I had disappointed her from the bottom of her heart. We still have time. Talk to Kyoko-san. Talk to your other parents over the phone. Try cooking some food, whatever. Just try doing as much as you can.
ケンイチの役立たず。
She puffed out her cheeks. I can make it so you never wake up if you want.
いいよ、もう。
Только flung herself on his bed, on her, her bed. See you tomorrow. Her utterly despondent sigh weighed heavily on my mind as I left her room.
Morita-kun, just いいかしら?
Choco-san was still talking to his mom, no matter how much trouble she was causing her. I bought you a rice cooker for your birthday.
Arigato.
So, what is it?
Toka no koto nan dakedo.
I'm sure it is. Not like there is much point in talking about the weather.
真面目に聞いてよ。
Let me tell you something. Your worries are totally insignificant in the face of what I have to deal with every day. I can never quite be sure if the world is going to end tomorrow or not, you know? Keeps me awake at night. Now, if you'll excuse me, it's time for my body purification ritual. Please do not disturb me.
悪かったわ。私ももっと心に余裕を持てって言いたいんでしょ?
Yeah, you got it. I'd have started questioning the degree of yours if you hadn't really. Just a bit of dignity crept into her expression. Kyoko-san, now's the perfect time to use your obligation.
え?
Order you to stay with you.
ふざけないでよ。もう義務なんかに頼らないって決めたのに。
There's nothing wrong with taking the easy way out. Do it. Come on, do it.Order her around with that lovely skull of hers. Kyoko-san's face darkened. I guess he had gone a little too far with that joke.
義務で、トーカの自由を奪ってしまったわ。苦しめてしまった。
She growls to no one in particular. I want the angst.
やっぱり、血のつながった母親の元に返すべきよね。
Who knows nothing about her?Where the hell is your confidence, Kyoko-san? Haven't you guys been getting along great recently?
だって…
Well, if I took Kyoko-san's past into consideration, I could sort of understand where she was coming from.
なんと言われようとも、私はトーカを傷つけてしまったから。
ん? You mean the burn?
そう。やけどを負わせてしまったのは私だし。
It was an accident. There's nothing you could have done about it. Her shoulders tremble slightly. Huh?
もっと、私の親が、ちゃんとした親だったら、私ももう少し、どうかにいい教育ができたのに。親のせいにしても、始まらないのだけれどね。
I noticed then offer Kyoko-san the same proportions that I had offered Toka earlier. How about getting some sleep? You can think about it all of this tomorrow.Kyoko-san looked like she had more to say, but I guess she couldn't find the words. She really just didn't want to be left alone, all alone. She offered me the same despondent sigh as Toka then returned to her room. It was almost like there were two kids living here and I was the parent.
Ohayo, Oka-san.
Ohayo.
An awkward greeting appropriate for an awkward breakfast. But you could hardly call it a breakfast though. I had prepared a simplistic meal consisting of rice with a soy sauce on it, but they refused to touch it. Oh, did I not put enough soy sauce on?
いいえ。
ごめん、私もいらない。
Ah well, soy sauce on rice was an acquired taste after all. Then again, the lack of appetite was probably unrelated to the cuisine place in front of them.
Toka.
Kyoko-san looked straight at Toka.
Nani?
Toka shifted her line of sight upward, looking eyes with Kyoko-san. She was probably trying to gauge her mood.
今日の予定は?
そうだね。ちょっと気分が悪いから好きなことやって過ごそうかなって。
また漫画?お小遣い足りてる?
うん、足りてるよ。今までずっと使ってなかったし。
そう。ね。今までお金の使い道を奪ってたのは、私よね。
あ、違う。そういう意味で言ったんじゃないよ。
うんふん。
ええ、わかってるわよ。ただ、私がおかしかっただけ。
お母さん、本当に
どうしちゃったの？疲れてるの？
トウカさん、allowed yourself to slouch。
なんでもないわよ。トウカこそ疲れてない？
大丈夫だよ。それより肩もみしてあげようか。
Yeah, that'd be great. Let's do it, do it. I sit down and put in my bucket token.
いいわ。なんだか恥ずかしいし。
そう？
Just then the doorbell rang.
これって。
We had gotten a delivery. Or rather, Toka had received a gift.
どうやら、コウキとサチオさんからのようね。
That's all.
あ、開けてみてもいい？
ダメとは言えないでしょ。
I mean, you can. Kyoko-san watched as Toka slowly unwrapped the package her arms crossed. There was a small heart-shaped box inside, sealed with a pink ribbon. Maybe they sent you some sweets? Toka carefully undid the ribbon and lifted the top of the box. It contained an assortment of cakes.
Tezukuri kana?
I took a look at the box. There was no brand name on it.
Taberareru no kashira?だって都会からこんな田舎まで日にちが経っているっていうのに、それに今は真夏でしょ。
Right.
大丈夫だよ。バターケーキだし、ジャムとか塗ってないみたいだし。
Yeah. Look, they even went to the trouble of wrapping them all in vinyl individually. Looks like they used some antioxidant too.
そうね。ごめんなさい。
Mm-hmm. Well, more importantly, there is a card in there too, you know?
あ。
どこ took the card?
なんて？
読み上げるね。トウカへ、今まで本当にごめんなさい。このケーキはお父さんが焼いたものです。よかったら、京子さんと食べてください。
Kyoko-san looked severely irritated for just a second. Kyoko-san?
Nani?
Nothing.
Ja, minna de tabeou yo.
Sounds like a damn fine idea to me.
Watashi wa enryou shite oku wa.
Obviously.
Doushite?
Toka. Toka. Please.Please stop being fucking idiots. Like, come on. I mean, I understand the situation, but she's been ridiculously stupid for some bizarre reason.
食欲がないのよ。
I mean, also, yeah, they didn't eat, basically, rice right now that was prepared for them. Obviously, that's another reason you can say. Come on, don't be party pooper. You can just eat a little bit.
二人で食べなさい。私はちょっと仕事をしています。
Work.
そうよ。そろそろ新学期も近いでしょ。
Yeah, I guess.
一緒に食べようよ。
忙しいのよ。またにして。
仲良くしようよ。
Kyoko-san marched off into her room holding her breath. Man, my soy sauce and rice combo must have tasted pretty shitty.And she marched right back out of it as soon as I cracked my lame joke. What? Oh, sup? You said that you wanted some delicious cake after all? Kyoko-san ignored me, she walked over to Toka and came to her house.
お礼言っておきなさいね。
え？
わかるでしょ？
あ、でも、向こうの番号、わかんないよ。
電話に履歴が残ってるでしょ。
そっか。ごめん。
Kyoko-san, there is no reason to get so worked up about this.
怒ってないわよ。
And then she returned to her room once more. Toko looked back, down in the box of cakes and heaved one of her customary sighs. Noon was about to pass us by and we still hadn't so much as touched the cakes.Toka had lain on the couch the entire time, complaining that she felt unwell. Toka, aren't you gonna close him? She responded half-heartedly, then sat up.
もしもし、トーカです。あ、お母さん？
あは、まあ、もれじ
ゃ。うん。お母さんはお母さんだから、呼び方はお母さんでいいんだよ。
うんふん。
それより、ケーキありがとう。うん、届いたよ。手作りなんでしょ？え？ああ、そうなんだ。いいね、そういうのも。あ、まだ食べてないけど、とりあえず、お礼言っておこうと思って。うん、京子お母さんにそう言われたの。え？お母さん？うん、元気だけど。うん、ちょっと、機嫌悪いかも。うん。でも、いつも辛そうだから。一回、家出みたいなことして、ひどく悲しませちゃったことがあって。うん。正直、今、ちょっと悩んでる。え？迷うようなら、お母さんを選べってこと？
Ну, к целой коки инсачивайся, жизнь зашить, что сколько кёку-сан?
Ун, мо чё-то, кангайте миру, не? А, аригато, симпай ште курете. Ун, мата дэнва суру, не?
Вази мам хэппи?
Ватаси о, ока-сан тэ, ёнде курэру но, тэ...
What was that about just choosing Kyoko-san if you didn't know what to do? But that attitude might just end up making Toka even more confused. They're thinking about her, and that basically will kind of make her do the opposite. So you've pretty much figured out what your other parents are like.
優しいよ、すっごく。
Have you ever thought that you wouldn't mind living with them? She frowned for a moment, unable to find an answer.
まだわからないけど、やっぱり会ってみたいとは思うよ。
I'll get to the points. Who do you prefer, Kyoko-san or them? I made sure to smile.
それは、そんなの比べられないよ。比べたらいけないと思う。ああ、でも、比べちゃうんだろうな。
She sighed again. Why don't you just eat some of that cake for now?
そうだね。
She stole a fleeting glance at Kyoko-san's room before reaching for the cake. The door was shut firmly. She had probably heard Toka's phone conversation from within the room.Alright! Let's actually take a break. I need to go with dogs. And stuff. So yeah. That's fine. So yeah, see you maybe in an hour or something.